Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. You know, prisons aren't meant to house the best of the best, but it can still come as a shock just how dangerous, violent, and deplorable some of its inhabitants can be. No fluff for this archive. We're just going to launch right into the top 10 most dangerous prison inmates on Earth. Now, before we get started, please subscribe and click that bell for future notifications on our videos. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and be sure to leave a comment for us with your thoughts.
Number 10, Eric Rudolph. The topic of abortion has been a hot button issue for years. Eric Rudolph took an extreme stance when he bombed an abortion clinic as part of a series of four bombings. In 1996, Rudolph, a member of the Army of God extremist group, orchestrated the Centennial Olympic Park bombing during the 1996 Summer Olympics. It was part of a series of four bombings between 1996 and 1998 related to Rudolph's beliefs against abortion and homosexuality. Over the course of his spree, the Olympic Park bomber killed two and injured 111, earning him four consecutive life sentences without the possibility of parole. Number 9, Michael Swango. We like to think we can trust our doctors, but Joseph Michael Swango proved that trust can be a dangerous thing. According to the trial that landed him in prison with three consecutive life terms without parole, Swango was accused of killing as many as 60 patients and co-workers. Swango often poisoned his patients, known to administer an overdose of that patient's prescribed drug. As for the co-workers he killed, his weapon of choice was arsenic. Number 8, Lisa M. Montgomery. These lists are often stacked with men, but Lisa Montgomery earns her spot for the ruthless 2004 murder of Bobby Joe Stennett. Surprisingly, the murder wasn't even the worst of Montgomery's actions. At the time of her death, Stennett was pregnant, posing as another pregnant woman named Darlene Fisher in a rat terrier chat room. Montgomery earned the trust of Stennett to a point where they finally met. On December 16, 2004, Montgomery strangled Stennett and cut out her unborn infant. The following day, Montgomery was found with a still alive newborn and later was sentenced to death, though a previously unmentioned mental illness could change her sentence. Number 7, Charles Manson. It doesn't take brute strength to be a dangerous person. As Charles Manson proves, sometimes it's about being able to manipulate others to do your bidding. Manson was the leader of The Family and orchestrated the murder of Sharon Tate, but wasn't present for the crime. Manson was able to manipulate Charles Watson, Patricia Krenwinkle, Susan Atkins, and Linda Kasabian to carry out the deed instead. The leader of The Family had gathered a group of around 100 followers, which was thought to have been connected to 35 murders, though never tried for. Manson passed away in 2017 of natural causes, though it's possible he still has an influence over some. Number 6, Rodney Alcala. Also known as the dating game killer, for having made an appearance on the game show during his killing spree on July 24, 1979, Alcala was arrested for the murder of 12-year-old Robin Samso, though it was far from the first time he had had a run-in with the law. In 1968, Alcala committed his first known crime by beating and raping 8-year-old Tally Shapiro. He fled California to avoid arrest and moved to the East Coast under the name John Berger. Shortly after his arrival in New Hampshire, 23-year-old Cornelia Michelle Crilly was found raped and strangled to death. Shortly after, Alcala earned a place on the FBI's 10 Most Wanted Fugitives list. Alcala's full list of crimes later included the assault of a 13-year-old girl, the rape of 15-year-old Monique Hoyt, and photographing nude teenage boys. The alleged list of Alcala's victims is thought to stretch to 130 people. Number 5, Tyler Bingham. The Aryan Brotherhood prison gang is among one of the most dangerous, if not the most dangerous prison gang in the United States. several people from the Aryan Brotherhood will wind up on this list, including Tyler Bingham. His murder conviction was enough to paint a nasty portrait, but Bingham proved how dangerous he was when he became a lieutenant of the Aryan Brotherhood. In 1997, Bingham was connected to a race war and in 2006 was put on trial for ordering 20 murders and assaults. Bingham was sentenced to a life sentence with no possibility of parole after avoiding the death penalty. Number 4, Pedro Rodriguez Filho. Connected to upwards of 100 murders, Pedro Rodriguez Filho of Brazil was sentenced to 128 years in prison. His life of killing started at the age of 14 when he killed Vice Mayor of Alfinas, Minas Gerais, for firing his father for stealing food from the school he worked at. When Filho found he felt who the real thief was, he killed him. When a woman he lived with, Maria Aparecida Olimpia, was murdered by gang members, Filho went on a killing spree to find out the identity of the gangster involved in her death. At 18 years old, he had killed another 10 people. Filho then murdered his father for killing his mother, cut out a piece of his heart, and partially chewed it before throwing it away. Even in prison, Filho couldn't keep from killing. Number 3. Barry Mills. When Tyler Bingham incited the race war of 1997, he didn't act alone. Barry Byron, the Baron Mills, was working alongside the lieutenant. At 21 years old, Mills was incarcerated for armed robbery and has been in and out of jail ever since. During each stint in prison, Mills rose through the ranks of the Aryan Brotherhood, eventually becoming a leader and became responsible for the expansion of the gang in federal and state prisons. Mills has been connected with drug trafficking, racketeering, conspiracy, murder, and in 1979 was convicted of nearly decapitating a fellow inmate at a maximum security prison. Number 2. Thomas Silverstein. Often labeled the most violent prisoner in America, Thomas Silverstein was first arrested in 1971 at the age of 19 for armed robbery. 6 years later, he was back for 3 more armed robberies. He was in and out of prison for years and eventually joined the Aryan Brotherhood. In 1983, he was placed in solitary confinement after murdering prison guard Merle Klutz at Marion Penitentiary in Illinois, and there he's been ever since. Before his 24/7 stint in solitary, Silverstein was an Aryan Brotherhood leader and was allegedly connected to the murder of DC Black's gang leader Raymond Cadillac Smith after Smith was found stabbed 67 times. Silverstein is in the middle of a life sentence with the potential release date of November 2, 2095, at his very unlikely age of 143 years old. Number 1. Ramzi Youssef. At the heart of the 1993 World Trade Center bombing was Ramzi Ahmed Youssef. The Kuwaiti-born militant was also accused of being involved in the bombing of Philippine Airlines Flight 434 and the Banjinka plot, a large-scale attack that, if not foiled, could have resulted in the death of Pope John Paul II and passengers of 11 different airlines. Youssef was also allegedly tied to the attempted assassinations of Benazir Bhutto, former Prime Minister of Pakistan, a planned bombing of the Israeli embassy in Bangkok, and the bombing of a Shiite shrine in Iran that killed 26 people. In 1995, Youssef was arrested and later sentenced to life imprisonment with no parole, plus 240 years. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, click the bell, give this video a like, and leave your comment below.